Hello guys, and welcome to Power BI Zone. Today we are going to discuss one of the most commonly used function in DAX. It's called filter. So let's take a look at the important concepts that will be applied while using the filter function. The syntax is very simple. You'll have two parameters. One is the table that needs to be filtered, okay? And the other is the filter itself. So let's say there is an amount column and you want only the values which are greater than zero, or there's a region column and there is a country called France, so you have to apply a filter on region equal to France. So these are the two parameters that needs to be passed in the filter function. The return type is going to be a table itself. So a filter will always return you a table. Now, you can, another remarks if you see, you can use this filter function to reduce the number of rows in a table that you're working with. Remember, so once we're using the filter function, ideally it is used to reduce the number of rows, okay? This is a point that needs to be taken care of. And generally how it is used is the usage of filter function in DAX. So either you can go ahead and create a separate table using the filter function, or you can use the filter function with another function like calculate, and these two in conjunction with one another can be used to create a measure. So for the best practices, you can refer this particular link. Okay, everything I'm giving in my blog post called powerbizone.com under articles, you can go ahead and get this, whatever I'm writing. So let's quickly dive into the practical sessions and see how filter is working. Okay, so this is my financial sample file that you get with Power BI. Okay, so if you go to the data pane and check what is the data of this financial file, you see these are the important columns that we'll be using: segment and country and sales. Okay, so let's see how we can use the filter. And to explain it better, so I have created four examples. You see this, and the naming conventions I have kept accordingly. So this is example one, this is example two, EX2, and these are the two measures, right? So what is the difference? You see a small calculator symbol over here, right, which says that these two are my calculated table. Okay, and over here you see there's no table, there's only a single calculator. That means these are the two measures. So let's start with our first example. So example one and example two, we are going to create a table using filter, and example three and example four, we are going to create measures using filter. I hope you're clear. Now let us go to example one. It is a very simple example, and this is based on the base table called financials, okay, and we are using just to simply filter the data. So there is a country column and there is a segment column. So if you go to the financials table over here, you see there is a country column and there is a segment column. So under country, what are the values we are having? Canada, France, Germany, Mexico, USA. What are the values we are having under segment? We are having these: channel, partner, enterprise. So let's say we want to create a new table, okay, which is not going to impact the number of columns. Remember this, only you are going to reduce the number of rows. At that time you will use filter. So you see this, there is a mid-market thing for segment, and there is a country, let's say Canada. So let's say I want to create a new table filtering country equal to Canada and segment equal to mid-market. So how you will write this? You'll just use the DAX over here. Let me try to maximize this so that you can see it clearly. Okay, hope this is visible. Now, so example one will be using the filter function over here. The first parameter obviously will be a table. So I have passed the base table, which is financials, this one, right? And the next is a simple filter condition. Now remember, this filter condition generally returns a Boolean value, so true false value, right? So I am saying give me those rows which are having country equal to Canada and segment equal to mid-market. And you see right now I'm the data pen. See this, whatever pane I'm hovering, a small yellow mark is over here, right? Which means you are in the current pane. So the current pane is data pen. Under the data pen, you see all the values are now filtered for Canada, correct? Only Canada is there, and for segment equal to mid market. Okay, this is the simplest use of filter. Now see carefully, I have intentionally kept the spelling of mid market as MAR in caps, MARK in caps, right? Even T in caps. So I am trying to tell you that even though the data is init cap, which means the initial starting of the letter is capital M and all the others are small letters, but this is case insensitive. So even if you write like this, you will always filter whatever is going to come in the this particular column. It does not matter whether the capital MARK is like capital or it's in small letters. It's always going to filter as long as the spelling is correct. That's it. So intentionally I have written it so that you can understand that it's going to filter both the segment and the country. So this is the first usage of filter. I hope this is very simple. You got it. That's it. Now the second example also, I'll be creating a table over here, but this time around what I have done is the same example, right? Country equal to Canada and segment equal to mid market, but I have stored these values. See, remember when the presentation was beginning, I told you that the return type of filter is going to be a table. Now this variable that I am creating, okay, now you have to learn the variables as well in DAX. So variables can either store different kind of values. It can store entire table, or it can store a singular value as well, right? So in this case, I'm storing, my filter is returning an entire table by filtering country equal to Canada and segment equal to mid market. This particular table is going to get stored in this variable, which I have named as filtered table, right? And this, I am passing this filtered table to another variable, okay? And I am only selecting three columns from there. Remember I told you that filter will always filter the number of rows. It will not change the number of columns. But let's say that there is a requirement where you need to fill, where you need to only get these three columns, country, product and sales, right? So for that you use another DAX called select columns. Very simple. For using this DAX, you will just get these three columns from your finance, from your filtered table. So the first variable stores a table, the second variable uses the value of the first variable, okay, and only selects these three columns, and then using the return function I'm going to return the this particular table, this particular variable rather, okay. So ultimately this is going to be the result of it, three columns, okay, filtered for Canada because I have already filtered this, and mid market all obviously, but I'm not selecting the segment over here, the column, that's why you're not able to see the segment equal to mid market value, okay. So I hope you are clear with these two examples. I'm creating this these two tables using filter. Now coming to the third example, which is measure, how you will write a measure using filter. Over here there is a catch. As I told you that you know, when you write filter with a measure, generally it is used with in conjunction with a with another function. This time it is calculate. So as you're aware, the function, you know, the first argument for calculate is an expression. So I'm just getting the sum of sales, but I'm filtering for country equal to Canada, correct? So it will, if you go to the base data and if you understand, all my country is Canada, right? So where is the sales column? This. So it will sum up all my sales for Canada and return it. That's what the visual is doing, right? But over here, remember one thing, as I told you in the earlier video, if you have not seen my video, go and see the video for row context versus filter context. For each and every row in this table which you are seeing, there is an internal filter context applied. So the first row is for Canada and year 2013, second row for France 2013, third row for Germany 2013, and so on. correct? Using this filter function in conjunction with calculate, we are just simply calculating the sales for country equal to Canada. That's why you are seeing this value, right? 5175 as the sales for Canada. Similarly, again the sales for Canada, 19711. Rest all things are empty. Correct? Now, this, when you are going to use the filter function initially as a measure, there are two ways in which you can write this particular second expression inside the calculator. Either you can use the filter function and write it explicitly, or coming to my fourth example, simply without the filter function also you can give country equal to Canada. Right? Now think, what is the difference? Same thing I am doing, example 3 and example 4, but one using the filter function over here, look, the keyword equal to filter, the other without using that filter function, only I am filtering a Boolean value of country equal to Canada. Now these are the two outcomes. You see, the same value for Canada is repeating when I am not using the filter keyword, right? Look, so this is the value for 2014 which is repeating for Canada, and this is the value for 2013 which is repeating for Canada. Now why am I getting the blanks over here and not any blanks over here, and the value is repeating? Can you guess? So for the second one, what it does is, when you are using the filter function, as I told you, there is already a filter context for Canada, right, for the first row, so this is fine. For the second row, there is already an internal filter context for France. What it is doing, it is applying an AND condition, right? And on top of that, it's saying, okay, I'm already having a filter context for France, and I am applying one as well for Canada. So so for France also and Canada, it is not true, right? That's why you're getting null. Similarly, Germany and Canada, so null. Mexico and Canada, null. Over here, Canada and Canada, this is true, right? So that's why you're getting the value of over here. But on the other example 4, which is without using the filter context, if you see this, it is without using the filter keyword, which is just the country equal to Canada without the filter, right? What it does, it simply ignores the filter context. So it will ignore the filter context for France, and it will override it and it will put it for Canada. Similarly for Germany, it will ignore it for Germany and it will override it using Canada. So since this is overridden, that's why you're directly getting the value for Canada repeating for each and every row. This is very important. Hope this is clear. Okay. And for more, I have written it in my blog as well. You can go to Power BI Zone and you can actually have the difference over here. See, usage of calculate function with and without the filter function. Okay. So I hope you are clear. If you are liking my videos, please go ahead and subscribe to this channel. It will give me huge lot of inspiration to go ahead and make further very useful videos for you. Thank you for all the love and support, guys. Thank you. Bye-bye.